गुड आफ्टरनून। गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
रिगार्डिंग प्रीवियस क्लास एज वी डिस्कस अबाउट थीटा एंड थीटा इन देर आर फॉर ट्राइंगल देर थ्री एंगल्स वन इज 90 डिग्री अदर्स आर सम एंगल्स थीटा वन और थीटा टू. In case if you take, we have pointed the angle theta, some angle theta. Instead of this, someone has why you are finding only that theta, we can't find the other angle theta. So if you find that angle, for example, theta 1, if you got 60 degree, theta 2 will get 30 degrees. So the sum of all the say, three angles will be equal to 180 degree. But always you should remember that our convention is top drops with the clock. So we'll, from the top, the only that angle we'll be considering. Okay, from top drops with the clock, if we get 30 degree also, the other angle will be 60 degree, that you need to consider, not the 30 degree angle. Okay, the 30 degree angle is for reference, what should be the other angle? Okay, hope you understood this.
Last problem on the theoretical method of solving Mohr circle problem. And then next we'll, from tomorrow's class, from Monday's class, we'll go ahead with Mohr circle through graphical method. Next week, I should be able to complete Mohr circle with graphical method, using graphical method. Okay, for that, I will give few instructions that you should follow. Have you solved this problem? 80 minus 100. I think I have solved this problem. I'll solve this problem. Last problem on theoretical method of solving Mohr circle problem. The problem is like this. A point is subjected to, the member can be subjected to any force, but at that point what we're considering, this is the force, okay? This is 80 MPa. 80 MPa is tensile. 80. Bread. See the sign. And this is 50. Now one of you unmute your mic and tell me sigma x, sigma y, and tau. And theta is given. One of you unmute your mic, sorry. This has to be. Vertical. This is 70 degree. Now, one of you unmute your mic and tell me sigma x, sigma y, and tau. And theta.
Raghavendra, can you tell me?
Sir, sigma x plus 8a.
Give me a moment, I'll write. Sigma x, 8a.
Sigma y is minus 100.
Minus 100. Tau?
Tau is 50.
This is minus 50. Negative, I told you. Downward is minus 50. Theta is?
Theta is minus 70.
Minus 70. Correct. Okay. Thank you. We'll go ahead. First, as usual, this is the plane. If you say this plane, which is inclined at certain angle. First, you can find the normal force on the plane and tangential force. Now, you should be in a position to tell all the values to me. It should not be difficult. You are solve many problems. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x and sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta plus tau xy sin 2 theta, which is equal to 80 minus 100 by 2 plus 80 plus 100 by 2 cos minus 140 minus 50 sin minus 140. Tell me sigma n. Sigma t or tau in t, which is equal to minus of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sine 2 theta plus tau xy cos 2 theta, which is equal to minus of sigma x, it's 80 plus 100 by 2 into sine minus 140 minus 50 cos minus 50 cos minus 140. Tell me sigma t. What is sigma n? Chetan, what is sigma n? Chetan KV, what is sigma n? What is sigma n?
Minus 46.
Minus 46. 46.80. What is the unit? What is the unit?
Newton per
mm square. Sigma t? Newton per mm square. We found sigma n and sigma t. Now we'll go to principal stresses. Sigma 1, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus root
sigma x minus sigma y by 2 the whole square plus tau square xy is equal to sigma x, it's 80 minus 100 minus 50. 80 minus 100 plus root 80 plus 100 by 2 the whole square plus minus 50 the whole square. Therefore, sigma 1 is equal to sigma 2, which is equal to sigma x. Only sign changes in between here. Plus or minus, you can write sigma 1 comma 2 directly as plus or minus like this. Sigma x plus sigma 1, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 minus root sigma x minus sigma y by 2 the whole square plus tau square xy. Tell me what is sigma 2. Sigma 1, 92 point?
Yes, sir. 92.95.
95 MPa sigma 2. Minus 112.96 MPa. Next. Tan 2 theta p, which is equal to, can you tell me the formula? Tan 2 theta p is equal to 2 tau xy by sigma x minus sigma y, which is equal to 2 into tau is minus 50, minus 50 by sigma x is 80 plus 100. At theta p, tell me. Give me a moment. Mean when we calculate it. Yes, tell me, what is theta p? Theta p? Why? What is theta p? Tan inverse 2 into minus 50 by 80 plus 100, then divided by 2. How much? How much?
Minus 15.10, sir.
Minus 14.53 we are getting. Minus 22 theta p is equal to minus 29.05 we are getting. 2 into minus 50 by sigma x minus sigma y. Two theta p is equal to minus 29.05 degree, or theta p is equal to minus 14.5. Are you getting this? Others, are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Getting this? Okay. Next, since sigma x minus sigma y, which is equal to at minus of minus 100 is positive, therefore theta p indicates the direction of sigma 1, that is theta p is equal to theta 1. We should not go with this sign. We should go, always should take sigma x minus sigma y, whether it is positive or negative. Since it is positive, sigma x minus sigma y, 80 minus of minus 100, therefore this theta p indicates the direction of sigma 1. There is sigma 1 in the sense theta 1. Therefore theta 2, which is equal to, if I say this is equal to theta p1, theta p2, theta p2 is equal to theta p1 plus 90 degree, which is equal to minus 14.53 plus 90. Can you tell me what is theta p2? How much Raghavendra? Minus 14.53 plus 90. Mekala?
5.47.
How much Tuti?
75.47.
75.47. Okay. Next, in order to represent that, show sketch and draw the xy plane. Through this, my clockwise rotation is negative. Minus 14.53 degree, and rotating clockwise direction. Assume this is minus 14.53 degree. This is theta p1, which is equal to 14.53 degree. Perpendicular to that will be my plane p2. This is plane p1, this is plane p2. Okay, and then this sigma 1 of magnitude 92.95 MPa on plane 1, sigma 1 positive, sigma 1 92.95 MPa on plane 1, sigma 1 is equal to 92.95 on plane P2, sigma 2 minus 112.96, minus sign is there, it's compression. Sigma 2 112.96 MPa, and also on other face for equilibrium, sigma 2 112.96 MPa. They are not accompanied with shear stresses. Okay, this is your principal stresses. Okay, next we will go to shear stresses. Okay. We know that theta S1 is equal to theta P1 plus or minus 45 degrees. Since theta P1 is equal to minus 14.53 degree is negative, therefore theta S1 is equal to theta P1 plus 45 degree, therefore theta S1 is equal to minus 14.53 plus 45. Can you tell me what is theta S1? How much?
30.47.
theta S1 30.47 plus 90, 100, 110, 120, 120.470. Okay. Now to find the sigma max, there is a tau max. We'll use the same formula, sigma t. Tau n t is maximum at theta is equal to theta s1. These are the planes of maximum shear stress. That is, theta s1 is equal to 30.47 degree. Let me substitute that. Sigma t is equal to tau n t is equal to minus of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine 2 theta s1 plus tau x by cos 2 theta s1, which is equal to minus of sigma x sigma y 80 minus 100 minus 50. 80 minus 100 sine 2 into 2 into 30.47 minus 50 na minus 50 cos 2 into 30.47. Tell me what is sigma t. This is sigma t max or min, right? Sigma t max. Time being, right? Sigma t. We'll see that. Sigma t. Tell me what is sigma t.
How much Mekala, Druti, Raghavendra, Sugun is there today?
Minus 102.956.
You are writing with a minus sign?
Yes, sir.
Okay, minus 102.96. Sigma t is equal to minus 102.96 MPa. Since sigma t is negative, it rotates S1 phase in clockwise direction. This runs with lot of synchronization, you should remember this. Okay, and you can write finally sigma t max or tau max. No one will ever say wrong for this. You can write plus or minus 102.96 MPa. Okay, next, sigma average, which is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2, which is equal to 80 minus 100 by 2 minus 10 MPa. Right? 80 minus 10. 80 minus 100 minus 20 minus 10 MPa. In order to plot the sketch, we'll take the x and y axis. x axis, y axis, theta s1 is 30.47 degree. Is positive, it should be rotated in counterclockwise direction like this from x plane. You indicate in the protractor 30.47 degree is equal to theta s1. This is plane s1. Perpendicular to it will be plane s2. Indicate the planes
since sigma t is negative, it rotates S1 phase in clockwise direction, minus 102.96 degree. This should be clockwise like this, 102.96. This should be like this, this would be like this, this will be like this, accompanied with the sigma average. Sigma average is equal to how much? Minus 10 MPa. It is compressive throughout, so indicate minus 10 MPa compressive like this. Sigma average is equal to 10 MPa compressive. Sigma average 10 MPa compressive. We can write 10. Have you understood this? I have completed the theoretical part. One question will be there on this. One sort of derivation you will ask, and one question will be there. Okay.
Sir, for second internal, can you give important questions?
When is the second internals, my dear? When is the second internals? You tell me.
23rd, 24th,
25th. I was not known. 23rd, 24th, 25th is the second. Is it offline or online?
That we don't know, sir. But morning they said 23rd to 25th.
Okay. 23rd is 14, right?
13.
13, okay, 13. By next week, I'll complete the graphical method also. The entire second model will keep for internals. I'll give an important question also. I'll also send you that I have made myself some Word document that captures few images through this MacMovies, and I have made some Word document. Okay, if you see that and if you practice those problems, more than sufficient. I'll be sending that to you also once let me complete this second model, graphical method. Okay. 20, 10, 13, 70, 20. Okay. I will try to complete three problems if I do it's more than sufficient. If you learn from that, it's more than sufficient. Okay, one more thing I would like to tell you. See, from next class, you should, from Monday's class onwards, you should be ready with graph sheets. You should be ready with graph sheet. And in that graph sheet, you should make divisions like this. At the center of the graph sheet, if in case that graph sheet should be kept landscape, that is not portrait, it should be landscape, it should be in the horizontal position. You should keep the graph sheet in horizontal position, and you should mark each division like this. You should mark each division as 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, and to left hand side 20. 40, minus 40, minus 60, minus 80, minus 100. See, this is sigma, I will tell you in the next class, sigma positive, this is sigma negative, this is tau clockwise direction, this is tau counterclockwise direction. Okay, here also, this counterclockwise direction, don't worry about this, you mark just here 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. Okay, here also this tau will be positive, counterclockwise will be positive. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. Each division you mark as 20, 40, 60. So each division has 20 MPa. 1 centimeter is equal to 20 MPa in both x and y axis. Okay, you do that, be ready with your graph sheet, two or three graph sheet you prepare like this. Okay, by another 3-4 classes, I should be comfortably able to complete this your Mohr circle graphical method. It's very easy. I'll use that whatever method we have followed until now, it makes a Mohr circle the simplest method. Very easy, okay? Nothing to worry, one stretch you can finish. But I will do it in SolidWorks, you should do it in your graph sheet. Okay, thank you. I'll be stopping at this point. Any doubts if you have, you can ask.
Should I stop at this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.